person. 60,000, is it the years I am living or the one that I live in the future? So if the one of the future, I will give you 200,000 as far as you can be able to give me. That I'm sure you will give me 200 years. They will go and collect one God and give it to you. No, I'm telling the truth. As some of you will pass and go and pay. You will ask someone that you say 50,000 that I see. You go and rob. You didn't ask him. Because they cannot answer it, because you don't know that you are smart to go to that place, because someone has told you. Is it what I'm going to live now? Or the one I live? So you have missed 60 years. I have been paying tax for 60 years. Now, tell me the one I'm going to see. What God can give you free, you pay unnecessary for that. God can change, He will give you life immediately. God has done so many things for so many of us without even letting us know. Unless your problem will tell you, you are going through death, but they say yes. But God has been doing it without even letting you to know. Because He said, I am your God, I am your life, I am your protector. So there's nothing you text to say thanks to God. That is enough. But all you say, thanks to Him.
Praise the Lord.
I say praise the Lord someone. So you must be thanking Him every time. Luke chapter 17.
11 to 19.
He said, we make it by what we get. But we make life by what we give, by our giving. We make living by what we get, but we make life by what we are given. So if you want to be a living soul, you must be able to be given and given. Luke 17, 11 to 19. We know the particular story of a dead leper that God Jesus Christ went away. They were shouting for help. And Jesus Christ decided to now have mercy upon them. 11. He said, and he came to pass as he went to Jerusalem that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And he entered into the certain village, there he meets him a ten leper. Ten men that were lepers and stood afar off. They stood apart because they cannot come close according to the law. And when he saw, and they lifted up their voice and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy. Jesus, Master, is one of the first appreciation. I believe in you as my Lord and personal Savior. That's the only key that can move Jesus Christ to come to them. Jesus, my Master. There's some people who come up to you and say, do you believe that I can heal you? You need their confirmation. Say, yes, Lord. There's some people who say, they bow down, they cry. So, the son of David, help me. So many ways Jesus Christ wants to get them to believe in Him. He said, Jesus, the Master, have mercy. And when he saw them, he said unto them, go and show yourself. He didn't do anything. Go, immediately they came, line up. He said, wow, you're wonderful. Go and show yourself. Go and show yourself to the priest. Some of them are going in dance. Some of them believe. But anyway, let us be going now. The Bible says, as they were going, they were made war. Oh. What? Look at himself. I am clean. He turned back exactly from that particular point. He didn't say, let me go. He came back again to look for Jesus Christ. Listen what Jesus Christ from 16. And now when he came, he said he fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks, and he was what? Samaritan. Now we go to 19. Look at what Jesus Christ said. And he said unto him, arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee. When something is made whole, something has been made complete. On the process of his sickness, on the days of that of sickness, he has been losing money. He has been going through pain. He will not wear good clothes. Some of the things that have been, you know, there's a thorn. There's a wound all over the body. And healing, you can be healed and you may not be made whole. He said, you have been made whole. Among all the nine, they were healed. But he is made a difference by making him whole. All the money he lost, everything that was sickness, taking care of himself, was restored by Jesus Christ. Thanksgiving opened up for restoration. Total restoration. Thanksgiving opened up for total restoration. Your faith has made you whole. They don't believe in the ability, they believe in the ability of Jesus Christ. Thanksgiving is returning all glory back to God. You must say, God, thank you. No wonder I said in Bible, they not pray and say, our Father, which are in heaven, hallowed be thy. First of all, you thank you. Imagine when you woke up in the morning and see your enemy while you don't save the money. The first day, you didn't save the money. Second day, you don't save the money. They will know you that they are waiting for you. One day you enter into your problem, you need their help. Of a car, make any man. This one, where they live? Live out! Suffer. And you are the one, good money, good money. Then you come and say, what is that? Go, go, go. What is that? Don't touch me. You talk to me. Everyone, because you know what it means by greeting. You should, if you meet someone that don't send you money every day to you, you should, the next morning you're walking and see, you say, I just want a bad prayer. You come back now. Because you don't want to see the face. You don't want. That's why before you do anything in the morning, make sure you say, Lord, we thank you. Lord, good morning. Good morning, Jesus. Say good morning to Jesus. Good morning to Papa God. Good morning, Holy Spirit. And they know that you are here. John chapter 6, verse 11. Praise the Lord. There's a gathering around Jesus Christ. Men and women and the children, and Christ was preaching. And unfortunately, Christ looked at them and said, give them food to eat. This is where he said, verse 5, he said, when Jesus Christ then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company coming unto him, he said unto Philip, where shall we buy bread? That this man, these may do what eat. Philip answered, 200 pennies worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little, take a little, take a little. They were coming to Jesus Christ and the Father, they were all hungry. He said, I need to give them food. The Lord is my shepherd and I lack what? He said, he will supply all my need according to his own standard. He said, I want to give them food. He said, wow, if you have 300,000, you cannot feed them all. But of course, there's the one small boy. I mean, loads of bread and two fishes. He said, bring it for me. Investing in it there to thank God. He himself is God, but he needs to thank Papa God. I'm not thanking him, multiply it. You know, sometimes when you are eating, I see some people when they are eating, before you know, God, thank you for this food. We find every false spirit in your food. Food you cook. Every poison. And we find it. You cannot buy poison. Poison is poison. Either you throw away the food or you eat it. The poison is there, it's already gone. You cannot buy the poison. Poison is not spirit, it's what they put there. But I'm telling you, you can say, Holy God, thank you for this food. If there's anything that is not worthy here, Jesus can go before you, remove them. I find yourself, somebody said, after going to your kitchen, you bend down, you cook what you want to eat, and you dish it out and give it in the devil. You are more than. And when you say, God, thank you for the ministry of cooking this food, for giving me for the money that I needed to cook the food, you are finding the food. Fish, onions, all of them, all the seven people, you are binding them, I bind everything, this, all the screen, and the people will be looking at you. Because they God, thank you for the food you are giving to us, because it's a privilege that you can be able to get the material, all those ingredients to cook their food, and the many people do not have it. So they say, thank you, you are binding. Don't keep quiet and looking at you, continue binding when you are done, you eat. The devil will need to just say thank you before we eat. You see how you will be so settled in your spirit. You settle in your spirit. You know, in this place, some people will come for Thanksgiving. God will tell you nothing to go and do. And sometimes you wonder why God wants you to
pathway to clear.
You want your pathway to be clear. When you say thanks to God, you will clear the bad one and open up the good one. Any moment you say thanks to God, the bad doors will close, the good doors will do what? And that's why we need to say thanks.
Praise the Lord.
I like the way Ephesians chapter 4 says, in everything, is let their moderation be known unto God. For God is one at one at hand. That you started before the India, you have to say thanks. Learn how to appreciate it. See, God is not begging you, it's a command. Hello? Thanksgiving is a command. It's not begging, it's not option. Thanksgiving is a command. You must give it thanks whether you like it or not. If Joseph had not angry when he was in a pit, Joseph would have died that place. If you read the book of Jonah chapter 2, you find that Jonah refused to obey the work of God, but it's only thanksgiving that saved him. At the point of the storm, he went down to the brink of the ship and hanged himself. They never caught him up. He confessed that he was the one that received the problem that he experienced. It's okay. What do you want us to do? He said, throw me inside the sea. I refuse to go and preach. The Lord said, you, Jonah, see how wonderful God has been to us. Some people say, go and die. God said, you, Jonah, you must preach to him now. Whether you run anywhere, you must preach. They say, oh, you're going, what's your way? Yeah, what's your way? What's your way? They are coming again. What's your way? So he said, well, shout! How did this guy? Never, sir. They enter. The man was wondering, where am I? This man don't fish. What stopped the fish from banging his head? What stopped the fish from banging his hand? He was given a command by God, the creator of the whole universe. And God allowed him to lie down in the belly of the fish 3 days. I believe first corrected Jonah. When he started 3 days there at night. This one had dry. No drinking, no urinating, no toilet, no hungry, no hunger at all. He don't know him. He said, Jonah, I'm going to see. He don't know Jonah. I'm coming back to Jonah. I need to make a confession.
Wow.
I need this. Sorry. But God is going back from me.
Okay. I need to do this one.
Read John chapter 2, verse 7 for me.
Do not talk about
it. Yes. Verse 7.
When my soul fainted within me,
yeah.
I remembered the Lord.
Yeah.
And my prayer came in unto thee into thy holy temple.
Continue.
Verse 8. They that observe lying vanities forsake their own mercy.
Forsake their own mercy. You young people to use gimmicks. Gimmicks to brainwash you. I was telling my children, I like the good King James Version where one of my daughters really said, people that are flattered, they will flatter you. He said, that you, not knowing God, he said, the flattering of the covenant. He said, you will be as you continue tonight. I'm coming here, we're going to that 11.
Verse 9. But I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving.
With the voice of what? A close mouth is a close destiny. He said, I will sacrifice unto you with the voice of war, thanksgiving. Okay?
I will pay that I have vowed.
Salvation is the law. That means that's a vow we made. He said, I promise you I will do that. Because the salvation coming from you. How imagine that I was saved by only a big fish. Bible said he commanded the whale to go and vomit him on a dry. You know what for nothing? Community somewhere. He said, leave it. Get it. If you're the only one on the sand, you got up again. Welcome to Nineveh.
merciful be God.
Okay, Daniel 11. Is anyone who knew New King James? I will read King James, but you see New King James. Daniel 11, that's 2. Daniel 11, verse 32. Then what will look in James? We will take them to the under King James. They will find it.
And such as do wickedly against the covenant shall he corrupt by flatteries. But the people that do know their God shall be strong and do exploits.
Praise the Lord.
Is anyone with New King James here?
No.
Yeah, you with New King James. Give me my microphone. I want you to hear you very well. I like the way that was started this morning.
Those who do wickedly against the covenant, he shall corrupt his flattery. But the people who know their God shall be strong and carry out great exploits.
Praise the Lord.
They will be corrupted through that. They know, they don't want to know God. They will be corrupted.
See, let's be sincere to answer.
Spiritual thing is higher than
natural thing.
But the problem today, we are so much acquainted with God that we say God is a merciful God. We believe we can maneuver everything. It's not true.
It is not possible.
Don't allow anybody to talk you out from the will of God. Because of one thing or the other, spiritual things are higher than anything you can think about. I thought about when the gospel was talking about Romans chapter 8, verse 2. That spiritual thing will suspend the natural thing. Any moment you obey and kill the will of God, anything that is in nature that is against the will of God in your life will be suspended. Until the will of God is endowed in your life. Spiritually give birth to physical. You know, whatever we are doing in his God looks so funny. Sometimes it looks as if it doesn't work, but God makes sense. Sometimes you look at it and you know what exactly you are doing. And that's one thing I learned from the God we worship. He don't talk too much. God don't talk too much. That's why you must be very, very careful to hear him. Once, I've not spoken. To once, have I heard him. That the all power belongs unto once, but he will give you conviction that I'm coming to you. Because two, he said you cannot go into anything without the witness of one, two people or three. So to give you the witness, I am the Lord. You will give this second time. You will wait till you are on this committee. Carry whatever I told you, you will see results. If you learn to say thanks, you will enjoy the best of God. Now if you look at a woman or a children, the certified woman. He said, woman is a single mother who has found herself at the end of her life, supply, and end of her ability to provide. End of her life, ability to provide for his children. Everything has run over. But when he decided to trust God, when the prophet came to me and said, can you give me? Imagine when you are about dying and somebody came to you and said, can you give me? There are some people that are so stingy that when they see their neighbor coming to their home, they will pack their food first. And I said, can't wait again. Of Coca-Cola, of my new one. Wait, throw your back. So now, when they tell their children, tell you that it's not around. Mommy says, I should tell that it's not around. You can take your policy game 50 times. What do you do? You told him, I love children. That's one thing they call them children. Anything you put them in their life, they will bring that before you give it to them. You tell this woman, like this, so. What they say, my mama said, you need something. But I didn't say so. Say, eh? And that's why you must be very careful what you impart in them, what you told them. Because any information you give to them, they don't release it to them. And they share with you. When they came to our place that time here in Ethiopia, his mother had been telling that his wife of landlord is a witchcraft. When they say, I saw you in the dream, they are flying, you are a witch. Everybody in the whole world looking what is happening. Because she cannot, I'm telling you, the woman was even up there looking. She said, I saw you flying, you are a witch. Now, you are a maca. Because she cannot be able to say you will not hear anything from someone else. for nothing. For in all things depends unto the Lord. For anything, for nothing. Anything, everything that happens in your life that is not beneath yours is nothing. Because there are things you cannot change. Christ blessed food that is cannot be able to feed even only disciples. He said, bring it. They brought it. He said, what will we take you? After prayer, he said, go and give to them 5 loaves of bread. 2 man in the drop. 1 by 1. He said, go. And you know one thing that happened? Escaped their mind. The apostle, it escaped their mind. Because, by the way, he made it 1, 1, 1 to share, because one person will not carry that all of them. Out of 5, he made it 5 baskets. Then that's why when he went to bread, then he got over 2 baskets of bread. He said, share. And the way sharing was multiplying. Bible said, at the end, they still have more than 5 baskets filled up that no one have ate. You may not see physically, but spiritually is there. You may not see physically, but spiritually, God will multiply you in Jesus' name. Say, instead of every woman, say, give me. I cannot give anyone, I cannot take care of my children. Everything is over. I cannot do anything anymore. And God said, give me. And the woman gave the food. He said, I am not run to my, he said, at my end, ability to provide for the family. What the Bible says in 1 Peter 17, if you read from verse 16, it says, the woman kept this food only for a day, a special day, they will eat it, and they will do what? Die. And again, Bible says it multiplied. They ate until the end of the famine. And my prayer is that God will open up our spiritual eye.
Amen.
He said, God's resources are unlimited and his timing is perfect. His resources are unlimited and his timing is perfect. There are never a hopeless situation in God. He brought a hopeless situation to a hopeful one. Whenever you trust and believe in him, he said, if you look at it, he said, when she trusted God with everything she had, God provided everything she needed. When she trusted God with everything she had, God provided everything she needed. Then the apostle in the Lord shall be as man. Can you trust God with what you have? Trust him. Say, what man watcheth in vain if the Lord did not watch over his city? In vain if God did not watch over his city. It's a kind of same problem. I left you because what will you remind God that you have done? What will you remind God that you have done? King Ezekiah in Isaiah chapter 8, after the battle with Sennacherib, in the last chapter 8, he was about him. And he said, Isaiah, go and tell him, get me a house in order, you are going to die. Imagine, do you know when this woman to announce you, you are going to die? You should be fear of that, death will even kill you before time. I told you a story of a young man here that wanted to go and check for HIV. People thought it's a funny thing. The guy will follow, when to go and pray somewhere, follow you from that man too. That place where you go to, you come out to go to the wall. He will follow me. I want to go to this. He said, I have to go to them. He said, I will check myself before you are not suffering for HIV. Pastor, what is it they look like HIV sign? I said, you are not suffering for HIV. You are not going to see. He said, Pastor, you don't understand. I said, I understand. He said, go. He went to Doria. And the nurse is very wicked too. After the nurse is there, they want to run the fire. I said, you are Mr. Kenneth. I said, yes, wow. Well, no, no, nobody will see you. Then they say, well, doctor will see you. That means, water don't pass what? But then you pass Gary, the guy, you will see the guy. The guy is going to, now, hit all over his hand, the leg, the shot, he put on short finger that day. All the shots was soaking with sweat. And doctor is going to look at it too. Whether the nurse went and told him, I don't know. If you come and say, yeah, Mr. Kennedy, come and say, yeah. He said, well, HIV is going to go on, huh? He got it, yeah. He don't know. He said, go to my office, I will explain to you. There are so many things. Many people are living many years now. So it's not a good thing for you to be afraid of. You can live, there are some drugs you live on, you go. The guy said, who's the other thing that happened now? here, we're coming by here. He said, my hand come up from the Lord, the maker of heaven. The guy sleep in a second. And the doctor hold himself, didn't want to talk. You see the guy, he's had all the time to say, that is it, and be a good, that guy, oh, no, that guy, don't pass away. That girl, I don't know what I did, that girl I met. Now, you're going to be carrying a check that I love it. You must say, well, I will write you some of the drugs. So you can buy it. It's very cheap. It's some of them are cheap. Some of them, you can take this baby. You can live your everyday life like a normal life. But they told him, that my baby shall be positive. The guy is sweating. Run away from the pastor. I don't say, but you're really dead. Yeah, yeah. See your promises. Everybody say don't give for a promise. Look at everywhere so. Because of the story HIV. May God help us in Jesus' name. Yeah. Let me tell you, our survival is only in God. You are victory. I said, thanksgiving open doors of victory. If you really want to enjoy victory, thank God. In anything, thank Him. He opens doors of victory. That's why David will know any moment there's a battle that you know that they cannot be able to fight, you will bring more sacrifice on your life. You know what he's doing. Imagine when a man made a silly mistake. God told him, you offended me by counting the numbers of Israelites. Who told you to do that? Are you out of your senses? God called a man. We're going to kill you anyhow. You see the Lord going to kill you. Then he shout, no kill them. I'm the one that's going to come and kill me. God said, you want to provoke David. You will not be a victim in Jesus' name. Yeah. Because those people that died before, they are victims. Victim of war. They were dying. David run to this side. The angel came to him and said, what do you want? One will fall into the heart of heaven. He said, no. I prefer falling to the hand of God because I know my faith of God will be merciful unto me. If you're falling to his enemy, I know the final. Look at the secret of the prophet. When I die, I look at him, I said, you know what I'm going to do? I said, go and get a place and offer sacrifice. He ran to go. So the man said, can I use the SAK? But I was there. I cannot give my God what does not know. He bought out a sacrifice. If you don't know that thing, God will not be angry. God is still the God that made that secret to Isaiah to make them leave. He will give you an exam, still give you an answer, and still pass you. So why can't I not trust him? Because normally, Isaiah will not know the secret. Isaiah can tell you, look at what you have done, God will give you and go. But God still learn the secret in the heart of Isaiah. The only way of the solution to this, thank God and offer sacrifice. God will grow all the red angels. If you didn't let it go, all of them will be there and run away. 2 Kings, I think chapter 2. King of Israel, Jehoshaphat, and the king of Ammon. It is still only offering. And all the men don't know that they went to Elijah. Elijah told them, you are going to go and conquer. He said, wow, you are going to win. Yes. They were so unhappy because at the point when the young man was angry, saw Ahab and said, you, what are you doing here? And because of the anger, they cannot come.